time no near I did. Keep your boat in me. A more time no near I did. Keep your boat in me. A more time no near I did. And near I did. Keep your boat in me. A more time no near I did. Eh, I did not match it. Sada very ma ni hu ye hu oko ma me eti ma ta fu na me fi iradi jina me chi sada very ma ni hu ye hu oko ma me eti ma ta fu na me fi so much every Jesus. Oh, who that is so able to walk a very new thing. My mama come at me, yeah, at me, yeah. Oh, that is she. Oh, I see. My mama so much every Jesus. Oh, that is so able to walk a very new thing. My mama come at me, yeah, at me, yeah. Oh, that is she. Oh, oh, I see. Oh, that is she. Oh. Jesus, who that is you say who work a very new thing. One mama come at me, yem, at me, yem, who that is she, oh. Me see, one mama so myself, you know, me ra Jesus, who that is you say who work a very new thing. One mama come at me, yem, at me, yem, who that is she, oh. Oh, me see, who that is she, yeah. Oh yeah, Jesus, Jesus Christ, oh yeah, oh your son, Umbro, Umbra. Oh yeah, Mira, Jesus, Jesus Christ, oh yeah, oh your son. Oh, me say, Umbra, Belchano, I'm for one, it's in Jesus, oh your son. Oh, me say, Umbra, Belchano, oh yeah, you for one, it's in Jesus. Me say, Umbra, Belchano. Oh yeah, Jesus, sir. Yes, it is so, yeah. Oh, your son. Me say, Mombra, me treno. Oh yeah, Jesus, sir. Yes, it is so, yeah. Oh, your son. Oh, me say, Mombra, me treno. I hear for one, it is Jesus, oh, your son. Oh, me say, Mombra, me treno.
no, Jifu Wahina.
Come on.
I say, come by the power of God. I say, come by the power of God. Oh, the power of God, the power, the power of God, the power, the power of God. Oh, 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 the power, the power, the power, the power.
Come on, move it, let's go. Come on.
Hallelujah. God, you are kind. I say, God, you are wonderful. My Lord, you are excellent. I say, God, you're so good. You're so good, God. I say, God, you are wonderful. God, you are wonderful. My Lord, excellent is thy name. Excellent. Excellent is thy name. Excellent is thy. God, you are wonderful. God, you are wonderful, my Lord. I say, excellent is thy name.
Drive for the Lord, somebody. They can drive for noise. Hallelujah.
When you're my shepherd.
osu runi asa asi ima mesi when you nyama stress osu osu runi asa asi. Let's take it again, let me see when you Nyamase, I say Lord, Osu, Osu Runi, Asa, Si, Sambe, Chiwa, Jeji, Opadiaje, Osu, Yasa, oh, me, Nyamye, when you, Nyamashe, me, Nyamye, Osu, Osu, Rudi, Asa, Asi, miss you when you, Nyamashe, when you, Nyamashe, I will has promised and he will never fail. He's faithful and I say he's forevermore.
Soon we will enter into a prayer of thanksgiving. Please, with all respect, you can sit down. And I'm going to read from Acts chapter 26, verse 22. That is our anchor scripture for our prayer. But to this day, I have had the help, emphasis, the help, which comes from God as my ally. And so I stand here testifying to small and great alike, accepting nothing beyond what the prophets and Moses declared would come to pass. So we are going to pray, open the gates with thanksgiving, and then this is how we're going to pray. Father, thank you for gifting us with the Holy Spirit in all our endeavors to help us. Father, thank you for the gifting of the Holy, with the gift of the Holy Spirit to help us in all our endeavors this very month. Shall we rise and begin to pray? In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, we thank God, just give him all the thanks. Thank him for the help of the Holy Spirit. Is God, he gave us the helper, who is the Holy Spirit. It is Jehovah himself who gave us the Holy Spirit, his excellency, to help us in this very month. And we need to carry it to him in thanksgiving. Mention the names of God and thank him. He's Jehovah Elohim. Thank him. He's Jehovah Rapha. Thank him. He's Jehovah Nissi. Thank him. He's Jehovah Shalom. Thank him. He's El Elyon. Thank him. He's Jehovah Chidenu. Thank him. He's Jehovah, our God Almighty. He's Jehovah Sabaoth. Just give him all the thanks. He deserves it for the help. Yes, he released his Holy Spirit to come and help us. And through, he has done it. Just thank him. He's God Almighty. Jehovah Sabaoth is his name. He has fought your battles for you. Just thank him. He's God Almighty. Jehovah Elohim is his name. Give it to him. It is all for him. We thank you, Lord, for an answered prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
Hallelujah. We're taking our second prayer topic. And before we do that, we'll be reading a scripture from Acts chapter 2. The verse number 42 to 47. Acts chapter 2, verse 42 to 47. Bible said, and they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and in breaking of bread, and in prayers. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. And all that believed were together and had all things common, and sold their possessions and goods, and parted them to all men, as every man had need. And they continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. Amen. We want to pray for ourselves and for Kloxark members that we will manifest as a sign and as a wonder for the remaining part of this year in the name of Jesus. Please, you want to stand to your feet as you lift up prayer and say, Father, we decree and declare by the power of the Holy Ghost that every member of Kloxark will manifest as a sign and as a wonder for the remaining part of the year in the name of Jesus. Bible said that Jonah manifested as a sign to the Ninevites, even as the Son of Man manifested as a sign to all generations. We want to pray that God will use you to manifest as a sign and a wonder in your generation, that Kloxark members will manifest as a sign in all our endeavors in the name of Jesus. May God help us manifest as a sign. May God distinguish every member of Kloxark to be a sign and a wonder in our generation in the name of Jesus. Let the Lord help us to manifest as a sign. May we manifest as a sign in the name of Jesus. Bible said that the apostles were used as signs and wonders in their time. May God use us as a sign in our generation. May God use us as a wonder to all that see us. May we be distinguished among our peers, because we will manifest the signs and the wonders of the Lord in the land of the living in the name of Jesus. May nothing by enemies hinder us from manifesting the intent of God concerning our lives in this generation. May nothing hinder our purpose here on earth in the name of Jesus. For we will be used as a sign and as a wonder to the generations and the ends of the world in the name of Jesus. Let the Lord help us. Let the Lord help every member of Kloxark that we will be distinguished, because we will manifest our giftings, we will manifest our purpose, we will manifest the vision of Kloxark, and we will be a sign and a wonder in this nation, Ghana, and we will be distinguished from every other association in this nation, because we will manifest our purpose and our will as a sign and as a wonder in this nation. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. In a short while, we'll be taking a prayer for the nation. In Isaiah chapter 25, verse number 5 through to 7, I read, like heat in a dry place, thou dost subdue the noise of the aliens, as heat by the shade of a cloud, so the song of the rootless is stilled. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of fat things, a feast of wine on the lees, of fat things full of marrow, of wine on the lees well refined. Verse number 7. And he will destroy on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. Our prayer is that, Father, by the blood of Jesus, we bind all satanic blindfold over this nation, and we decree the release of your visible glory over this land. Let's stand to our feet as we begin to pray for the country. Pray for Ghana, that the blood of Jesus will bind every satanic blindfold, every satanic agenda, satanic blindfold. The God of the heavens will bind it. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray that the Father in heaven, our Father in heaven, will bind all satanic blindfold over this nation. And we decree the release of visible glory over this land. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and pray. The Bible says that we have been raised with Christ and we are seated with him in the heavenly places. God has given you power. Christ has given us power. We are praying for the nation. Lift up your voice and pray for Ghana. Pray for Ghana. Pray for Ghana. Pray for Ghana. We are coming against every satanic blindfold. We bind every satanic blindfold in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice. Pray for Ghana. Pray for Ghana. We are coming against every satanic agenda, every satanic blindfold, every satanic manipulation, every satanic calendar against the life of God's people, against the life of the nation. We come against it by the God of heaven. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice. We are praying for our country. We are coming against every spirit of murder. We are coming against every attack of the body of Christ. We are praying for Ghana. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. We come against every attack of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. There is power on your tongue. The Bible says that we join hands with Christ. We join hands with Christ. There is power on your tongue. Pray for Ghana. Bind every satanic blindfold. Bind every satanic blindfold against the church, against Ghana, against Ghana. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Malota Sika. Ale Moli Paliata. Kalosa Teli. Pali Tolo Kalipa. We bind Kalosa. Emasita. Palota Tata. Limatoli Pakiata. Pali Sotokia. Pali Tata. Our God is strong. Our God is strong. We are binding every satanic blindfold. Limpakosete. Lianteli Paki. Limatosa Tata. Lema Malitali. Pakito Sateli Mayata. In the name of Jesus. Pasotelia. Father, we thank you. We thank you. In the matchless name of Jesus, we call it done. Let's take our seat.
Hallelujah. Shortly, we'll be going into our personal supplication. In Luke 21, the Bible made us understand that anything you ask shall turn to you for a testimony. Amen. So this afternoon, if you believe that everything you are going to be asking God shall turn to you as a testimony, why not be up on your feet? Or you take the position that best suits you. You want to stand, you want to kneel before God this afternoon and present your request before him. This is the moment. He said, you should seek ye first the kingdom of God and all other things shall be added. We have here, we have prayed for the country, we have prayed all kinds of prayers. And it's the moment to put our request before God, believing that he will do it unto us. Why don't you put a heart desire before him this afternoon, knowing that he is the almighty God. He is the all-capable God, and there is nothing too hard for him. There is nothing too hard for our God. He said, if you open your mouth wide and he'll feel it. Anything you ask him this afternoon, he has the capability to do it. He's all capable and he can do it unto you. Speak to him this afternoon concerning that heart desire, concerning that healing that you desire, concerning that promotion that you desire, concerning that forward movement. Ask God this moment concerning it, concerning that plan and purpose of your life. Lay it before God this afternoon and let him be the one to direct you and order your path. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's lift our voice as we pray. Father, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, we lift up our hearts before you this afternoon. Lord, believing that you grant that which our heart desires. Lord, hear us this afternoon from your throne room of grace. Father, Lord, grant unto everyone according to their desires. Father, Lord, meet everyone at the point of their needs this afternoon. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Let's put our hands together for the Lord.
Hallelujah. Righteousness, peace, and joy. Oh, yeah. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Righteousness, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. As the kingdom of God. Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Come on, come on, everybody. Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Come on, come on, everybody. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. As the kingdom of God. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. As the kingdom of God. Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Come on everybody. There is love in the kingdom. So much love in the kingdom. So much love in the kingdom. Come on everybody. There is love in the kingdom. There is peace in the kingdom. So much peace in God's kingdom. Come on, everybody. Oh, there's joy in the kingdom. So much joy in the kingdom. So much joy in the kingdom. Come on, everybody. There is love in God's kingdom. So much love. Come on, everybody. There is peace in God's kingdom. So much peace.
Hallelujah. If you're an heir of the kingdom, why don't you put your hands together for the Lord? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise God. I welcome you to this afternoon's fellowship. I want to thank God for the privilege and the leadership of CLOCSAG for making us, giving us an opportunity to meet here. Please, I want you to know that when we come here, we are in church. You don't need to be in the four walls of your church before you realize that you are God's presence. Say, where two or three are gathered in his name, he's there. And especially when we are praying for this nation, you see some people are not praying. Let's pray for God. He said, in the peace of this nation shall be your peace. So when we are praying, don't be psychedelic. Don't be nonchalant. Whatever happens in this, God forbid, nothing evil will happen. But you are not adding to the cloud. You are not adding to the prayer cloud if you are not praying for this nation. How do you express your love for this nation if you are not praying for this? When we lift up prayers like that, let's pray. Praise God. Let's pray for our nation by the grace of God and by the hand of God upon this nation. No evil shall befall us in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Holy Spirit, we welcome you this afternoon. Come, manifest yourself, speak through me, these lips of clay, grant utterance and revelation. I ask that every veil cast upon anyone be taken away. Let the voice of the blood of Jesus rebuke every contrary voice in the name of Jesus. Let light break forth and let every darkness be dispelled. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want to talk about the subject of power. Say with me, power. We know in Acts chapter 10, verse 38, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost, a personality of the Holy Spirit, and with power, who went about doing good and healing all, not some, all that were oppressed of the devil. For God was with him. Thank you. For God was with him. How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. The enemy does not understand any language apart from the language of power. Praise the Lord. He said, how terrible art thou in all thy works? He said, through the greatness, Psalm 110:1-3, through the greatness of your power shall the enemy submit themselves unto you. It's not by grammar. By the greatness of his power. Praise the Lord. Psalm 110, verse 1 to 3. And I read, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit down at my right hand until I make thy enemies thy footstool. The Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Root thou in the midst of thy enemy, not your friends, in the midst of your enemy. Root thou in the midst of thy enemy. It said, thy people, verse 3, shall be willing in the day of what? Thy power. When power comes, the willingness to do is released. Thy people shall be willing in the day of your power. Praise God. Praise God. Why are you a Christian if you don't like the power of God? Don't be a religious believer. I've told you, if the Spirit of God is not in the place, that place is dead spiritually. That's what it means. He said, as the body without the Spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead. Why would you want to go to God and not love His Spirit? And this is why we have duplication of spirits, familiar spirit. Remember, you know the story when Moses went to Egypt and he put his rod down. God knew, Moses said, how would they believe me? How would they know that you sent me? And he said, what is in your hand? He said, a rod. Put it down, turn to a snake, take it by the tail. God knew that the first point of contest would be the display of power. Praise the Lord. And therefore, when he went to Egypt, the first contest was to show them the I am that I am. Show that I am has sent him. Praise God. And he put his rod down. The magician's rod turned into a snake. Duplication of the original. Unfortunately, people like the familiar spirit. They like that one. That's why you collect something and put it under your bed. The Bible said their sorrows will multiply. Those who go after other gods. You saw familiar spirit at work when they put the magicians also conjured. You must go for clean power. Say it with me, clean power. But the rod of Moses swallowed up their rod. Rooted out in the midst of thy enemy, by the greatness of your power, thy enemy shall submit to them. That shall be your story. So you saw that God is a God of power. Why is he giving us power? Power for what? All power must lead to the glorification of God. And all power must lead to the salvation of souls. Praise God. Every power must lead to the glorification of God. Every power must bring the unsaved to Jesus. Hallelujah. Now you ask yourself, in the day of Pentecost, he said, you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost is come upon you. But before the Holy Ghost came, they were healing the sick. So which power were they using? Hello? Before the Holy Ghost came on them, they were baptized with the Holy Ghost. They were healing the sick. Which power was that? In John 3:34, the Bible said Jesus had the Spirit without measure. Don't be sleepy under this anointing. Praise the Lord. John 3:34. He gave him the Spirit without measure. Hallelujah. He said, for he whom God had sent speaketh the words of God. For God giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him. That is Jesus Christ. So Jesus' Spirit, the anointing, was without measure. Everybody's anointing is in dimensions. Are you with me? And therefore, if you begin to understand what is available, you can move from one dimension to the other. But Jesus' dimension was without measure. Hallelujah. And that's why you see a child of God suffering in an area. You go to church, yes, but you will be suffering in an area. It is not God's fault. God has made everything available for you, but you must understand what is yours and you must take it by force. That's why I said the kingdom of God suffered violence and the violent taketh it by force, not by play. Hallelujah. There are certain things that have remained. Listen to me. You read the book of Revelation. He said, John said, and I saw a door open. So the door is already open. But Jesus said, I come and I knock on the door. You are the one to open in your heart for him to come in. But the door in heaven is open. That breakthrough of yours is already open. I said, it's already open. You are the one who must take it by force. You are too gentle. You are too psychedelic. 2 days ago, I was preaching somewhere, and after preaching, I said, if you are sick in any part of it, put your hand there. Somebody had partial issue, sight issue was healed. Someone that had some swellings in the leg was healed.
The gospel of Christ must be demonstrated with power. Otherwise, they will not believe. This is why when Jesus came, he preached the gospel of the kingdom. That's what he preached. And that's why when you preach the gospel of the kingdom, it is followed with what? Signs and wonders. Accompany signs and wonders. Acts chapter 2, verse 20 to 22. Acts chapter 2, 20 to 22. Praise the Lord. And the sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into what? Blood, before that great and notable day of the Lord. Verse 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Verse 22. Ye men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved, say approved, of God among you. If Jesus come and he's the one that introduced these things to the marketplace, to the New Testament church in its greater dimension. It was there already, but he brought it in its greater dimension. He said, a man approved of God among you by miracles. Don't say you believe in Jesus and don't believe in his power and don't believe in miracles. They are false. The Bible said there will be false Christ. Even the Antichrist, when he comes, he will be doing lying signs. Praise the Lord. But this is original. A man approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in the midst of you, as ye yourself also know. Praise God. We are not serving a dead God. We are serving a living God. I'm provoking you today to believe in the power of God. Hello? It's not everything that you'll be crying. You have to use the power. Hello? Moses exhibited the power of God to the point that God is the one that told him, go and die. That means, you see, that's why in Jude 9, let's look at it. Jude 9 is one book. Jude 9. It said, yet Michael, the archangel, when contending with the devil, he disputed about the body of Moses. The what? Does not bring against him a railing because accusation, but said, the Lord rebuke you. Now listen, Moses had carried so much glory and power that he was refusing to die. Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 48 to 50. And the Lord spake unto Moses that self same day, saying, let's move. Get thee up into this mountain, Abarim, unto Mount Nebo, which is in the land of Moab, that is over against Jericho. And behold, the land of Canaan, which I give unto the children of Israel for a possession. Verse 50. And die. Do what? Have you seen your Bible before? And die in the mount whither thou goest up and be gathered unto thy people. God told him, go and die. Hello? Why? The body he has become a receptacle of the glory and the power of God that even death was afraid of him. That God had to command him. When they talk death, somebody will be thinking, hey, everybody will die. There are people who didn't die. Enoch was translated. He didn't die. Elijah was caught up. He didn't die. Not all of us will die here. Even before the rapture. That's the truth. Not all. Hello? The power was resident in his body. And that's why Satan wanted to duplicate. And so Satan wanted to contend with the body of Moses because the body carries so much glory. Remember, any spirit that will operate on the earth is illegal without a body. Are you following? That's why he said concerning Jesus, a body have I prepared for thee. And that's why we call possession. When somebody is possessed with demons, we possess. The spirit enters the body. So they wanted to contend for the body of Moses because the body had so much glory. Hello? Elijah prayed, 1 Kings chapter 8, and then fire fell, isn't it? And the Bible tells you in the book of James that Elijah was a man of like passion. He prayed that there would not be rain, and there was not rain. And he prayed that the rain should come, and the rain came. Why? What is the difference? That's the problem. What's the difference? What's the difference? What's the difference? Number one, ignorance. Number two, we are not thirsty for it. We think that those things that happen. He said we are in a better covenant. In other words, what we're supposed to see is supposed to be greater than what they saw. But the sin of limitation. Psalm 78, 41, 42. They've limited the Holy One of Israel. We have a limit. I pray that your mind be renewed this afternoon. There are certain things that will take power. But you must understand, power is in that. Next week, we'll talk about the dimensions of power. This morning, I came to let you know that you need power. Otherwise, he wouldn't tell them, wait, tarry in Jerusalem, Luke 24, 49, until you are endued with power from on high. From on high. Before the Holy Ghost descended on them. You remember Dorcas, who died and was brought back to life. Which power was that? The Holy Ghost has not come on them. Which power was that? I mean, you know the story when Jesus sent them out and they came back with testimonies that the enemy, that Satan was even subject to you. Which power was that? We need to tap into those ancient powers so that we see them manifesting in our lives. You are not a Christian. You are not a celebrating Christian. You are not called to show that how many cars you have. You are not a celebrating Christian. You are to show forth the power. If you don't like the power of God, then you are selfish because you don't want others to be saved. I pray that power be activated in your life tonight. If you don't like it, then you are selfish because and you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost has come upon you and you will be witnesses. Unto me, you will be witnesses unto me. How selfish can you be? Somebody need to be saved. Somebody need to come to Jesus. Somebody is dying. Somebody is going through certain things. The power of God will bring them out. It's in dimensions. So the dimension you are is the dimensional power you will exhibit. I pray that God will give us wisdom in the name of Jesus. Look at it. Genesis chapter 2, verse 19. Adam named the animals. Which power is that? And God was standing by, and God did not say anything. And he said, my son, yes. God was cheering up for Adam. He named all the animals. What power was moving in him? He named the animals, and that became their name. There was an endorsement direct when he named the animals. You have become a psychedelic Christian for too long. It's about time to roar. Now listen, when you see, you say Jesus, the King of Kings, listen to me. Jesus is not the king that took away the sin of the world. He's the Lamb that took away the sins of the world. Jesus said, I send you as lambs among wolves, and they return with testimonies. Does it mean that lamb is weakness? No. He's trying to let you know that the way to maintain the anointing is meekness and humility. Are you following? So that you don't get into familiar spirit. You don't begin to see yourself as something that they worship you. Praise God. He said that's why he was enthroned, the Lamb of God that was slain. Revelation 13:8, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. Revelation chapter 5, verse 8 to 10, through to 11 and 12, where is the Lamb that was slain to receive power? The Lamb, talking about that nature, the humility nature, the meekness. That means you reign by meekness. Hello? That is to say, after seeing all those powers, you don't act as if you are God. Praise God. Hallelujah. We need the power of God. We need the power of God. Power is in dimension. Without power, the enemy will be playing around. It's time to react. It's time to what? There's action and what? Reaction. It's time to react. It's time to react. It's time to react. Why do we need the power? For sake of time. Power to become the sons of God. John 1, 11 and 12. As many as received him, he gave them the power to become the sons of God. Even to those that believe on his name. And he came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, he gave them what? Power. Power for salvation. Power to become. He gave them power to become the sons of God. He gave them power to become the sons of God. Power to become. Power to become. What is the power for? To become the sons of God. Praise the Lord. Power to get wealth. Deuteronomy 8:18. Power to get wealth. That's why I remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. That's what we call prosperity. That he may establish his covenant. Power to get wealth. Power to get wealth. Power to get wealth. That he may establish his covenant. Power against. Matthew chapter 10 from verse 1. Power against the onslaught of the enemy. Matthew 10:1. Power against. Say with me, power against. That's the power to react against. Matthew 10:1. Hallelujah. And when he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them what? Power. He gave them what? Against what? Unclean spirit. Hold on. That's why, you see, you are under the bondage of fornication, under the bondage of drunkenness. And it's power against unclean spirit. Because, you see, this thing has controlled you. They've taken over. You need the power against them. Power against unclean. You don't like it. You are in it. You don't like it. It's gripped you. What it's saying is that he gave them power against unclean spirits. Power against unclean spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Certain things happening in your life that you don't like, you need the power of God to come out of it. I pray that this afternoon, that power be released upon thee. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. Power against unclean spirit. Praise the Lord. Power to heal. Power to cast out devils. Mark 16, 20, 15 to 20. Mark 16, 15 to 20. Our time is almost up. Mark 16. And he said unto them, go ye into what? All the world. Is Ghana part of the world? And preach what? And preach what? The gospel euangelion, which means good news, good news. So the gospel of the kingdom must be preached first. Are you following? And with accompanying signs and wonders, the gospel must be preached. I pray that now that grace to declare the gospel unto the unsaved, receive it in the name of Jesus. You see, go preach the gospel to every creature, not living thing, every creature, everything, non-living and what living. That's why Jesus spoke to fig tree. That's why Jesus rebuked the wind. That's why you can speak to the sickness, it will obey. Everything must obey you. And he said, verse 16, he that believeth, he that what? You don't need to be a pastor. You don't need to be an archbishop. You don't need to be a pope. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. But he that believeth not shall be damned. Verse 17, and these signs shall follow them that believe. Do you believe? Then in his name shall they cast out what? They will cast out what? Diabolo. They shall speak what? With new tongues. You say you don't believe in tongues. Do you read the Bible upside down or you read it in? You speak in new tongues. Some say, I'm afraid though. You see, every baby never. Every baby yeah, Jesus Christ did the moja at some of your kasa and in yankupon kasa. We are speaking mysteries unto God. Hallelujah. They shall speak with new tongues. And what happened? Verse 20. Let's rise up on our feet. Time is up. Verse 20. Let's rise up on our feet. Verse 19, sorry. He said, they shall speak in new tongues. Verse 18. They shall take what? Up serpent. And if they drink any what? Deadly thing, they shall lay hands on the sick. And they shall, verse 19. So then after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God. What is the right hand? The right hand of power. Yad, Y-A-D, symbol of power. Praise the Lord. Verse 20. And they went forth and preached everywhere. The Lord. You see, that's why you shouldn't be afraid. When you declare, the confirmer will confirm it. The Lord working with them. You are not working with yourself. You are working with one that has authority. That was commanded. The one who gave you the capacity to ask has the audacity to ask, has the capacity to do it. So he said, the Lord working with them and confirming everywhere. With what? Signs following. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Nami, Rabetami, Mune, Kaino, Nami, Nawo, Me, and Nawo, Nawo. One baptism, many infilling. In a minute, Holy Spirit, fill me again. In a minute, Holy Spirit, fill me again. Oh, legete frandi iko parada negeze gedaya. Aye men no kofo sagada. Fill me again. Fill me, fill me, fill me. Aseko brad. God wants to use you to save your entire family. You. To save your entire family. You are not in that household for nothing. God wants to use you to save your entire household. That's why you are there. He said, if a man is saved, he's saved together with his household. He
said, this is unto you and to your children's children.
Father, we thank you for this afternoon. Thank you for your presence in our midst. We commit everyone here this afternoon to your hands. We ask that your power will be activated in our lives. We ask that you will empower us with might in the inner man to believe, to prove that Jesus is alive. This weekend we declare will be our best weekend. We declare that every power of the enemy targeted at anyone is destroyed in the name of Jesus. We cover the leadership of Klosak in the blood of Jesus. Every member here, the mark of the blood is placed upon you. This weekend will be your best weekend. You will return with testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. Be blessed in Jesus' name. Let's share the goodness together in fellowship. Surely, his goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen. Peace. Remain blessed. Is that prof behind there? Is that prof? Praise God. See you next week. The Lord bless you.
In the name of Jesus, you are more than conqueror. In the name of Jesus, you are more than victorious. The powers of the earth have been given unto you to shake the devil off. In the name of Jesus, we're more than conqueror. In the name of Jesus, we're more than victorious. The powers of the earth has been given unto you to shake the devil off. Go shake, 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 shake the devil off. Shake, 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 shake the devil off. Shake, 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 shake the devil off. In the name of Jesus, I will shake the devil off. Shake, 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 shake the devil off. Shake, 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 shake the devil off. Oh, shake, 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 shake the devil off. In the name of Jesus, I will shake the devil off. In the name of Jesus, you are more than conqueror. In the name of Jesus, you are more than victorious. The powers of the earth has been given unto you to shake the devil off. In the name of Jesus, you are more than conqueror. In the name of Jesus, you are more than victorious. The powers of the earth has been given unto you to shake the devil off. Oh, shake, 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 shake the devil off. Shake, shake the devil off. Shake, 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 shake the devil off. In the name of